Paul, just summarise your emotions after a game like that, ending 2-1 defeat.
Yeah, I've just said in the dressing room, I'm sick for everyone, the players, the staff. Everyone puts so much effort into a game, and you can see it there, and the pitch culminates with the effort you're putting on the pitch. And yeah, it's cruel, but the game can be cruel. A couple of moments where we switch off and we get punished, but yeah, could have easily been 3 points. Then you think you're taking one, and then it's none. So yeah, but we've got to take it on the chin and understand why. So, but we'll deal with that on Monday. But if I'm looking at but that doesn't change the performance. The performance would have been the same. Some real good things. We've got some more players with minutes, some more players making the debuts for us, you know, stepped into the squad. So, yeah, we know how tough it's going to be, and we have to keep working to improve. But I'd rather be talking to you now with the 3 points.
In terms of the two late goals and how you finished with Ollie McBurney getting sent off as well, how frustrated are you with the way that the game ended?
Well, just the result. Yeah, of course we are 2-1. But listen, you could see how they celebrated what we've done to them and how we've played. And we've done that. Our players have done that. Our players who people write off have done that. So no one will scare us in this league. No one at all. We have to approach every game in that way. It's a reminder of how tough it is and how cruel it can be because you're playing against top players. But we've got to accept that, like I say, and be better. That performance will be good enough to win lots of games. Of course it will. So we've got to replicate it over and over again.
Good goal. Really well taken as well. You had to wait for your chance. Are you really pleased how Gus kind of kept his composure to finish it off after it
came? Good finish. Not believe, but we will speak about that this week. It was something we had. We could have easily got a chance against Everton towards the end and didn't do the same thing. It's something we spoke about a lot, showed it on video. We speak all the time about the little details. Little details, of course, at one end got us a goal at the other. But we had moments before that as well. We know Spurs were going to have a lot of the ball. They're a good side, and how they rotate and the space Madison takes up can pose your problems. But we defended it pretty well and limited the amount of efforts they had from inside the box. And that's big. So Wes made some good saves, but the majority of their efforts were from outside the box until the end, the goals. So from that aspect, we're very good, and we arguably had the best chance of the first half, and then a couple more. And listen, sometimes you might have to be that ruthless to get an away win in this league course, but we, I'll reflect on it, I'll look at it. Was it another improved performance? Yeah, of course it was, but I'd rather have had the points today.
Yeah, feels really tough. Felt like you really got under their skin in that second half because they seemed to lose their fluidity, the chances weren't coming. I mean, from your perspective, the fact that you've managed to do that against Spurs and Man City over recent weeks, that's got to take some heart from that.
Yeah, but they're the teams we're playing against, so we've got to be able to do it if we want to compete. They've been excellent so far this season, if anyone's watched them. Andrew's just won manager of the month, Madison's just won player of the month. And there's a reason why, and why they're at the top. So yeah, we worked very hard this week on how we wanted to play, and it would have been nice to get there, you know. But I can't not focus on all the good work that's happened. I need to recognise that and where we've done well this week, but also likewise where we need to get better, because that's our aim, to just keep improving. We've got players who are new to this club, who are new to this league. But like I said, nothing to be scared of.
Thoughts on multi-ball and added time today?
Mate, are we going to talk about the refs again or what? Listen, you know I'm not moaning about the game because I was doing it from 0-0, you know, and I went to see the ref at half-time at 0-0. I went to see 1-0 up, where 1-0 up, I was still saying the same things. Embarrassing, lost control. There's a focus from the referees to be looking at certain things, and they could just manage the game of football, please. Wes is getting told to take goal kicks quick. From the ball getting put down, he took less than 10 seconds on every goal kick. He's getting told he's going to be booked and sent off. What's going on? You know, you set up, you can see we played out from goal kicks. So we set up, Wes puts the ball down, we split. Then you've got to see what Spurs do to stop you, and then you make a decision off the back of that. Go and talk to the refs about half-time. They don't understand what I'm saying. Tell me, well, he's got to go along. Why? So we work all week on a certain thing, and the referee is going to tell us how we have to play the game. No, can't happen, but it's happening. Multi-ball comes over four times, five times. The ball boys are taking a mick and laughing at the referee, and he's allowing it to happen. What? It's crazy. VAR looks at a big centre-back jumping to Wes Fodringham, turning round and leading with his forearm stitches. Booking. And Ollie McBurney gets a booking for saying he's pulling my shirt. he gets a booking. So that's deemed the same offence. Crackers. Yeah, we need to get together and stop the people who know the least about football directing where the game's going, because they're ruining it. Ruining it.
In terms of Ollie McBurney, of course, it was a second yellow. I imagine there's not a lot you can do about that now.
So he's gone to ref and said he's pulling my shirt. That's what he said and shown, pulling my shirt, and he's been booked. Yeah, listen. Yeah. Yeah, has it affected the performance of that? No, it's affected, though. You said everyone's noticed it. The referee's performance frustrated the fans, frustrated us, frustrated Spurs, frustrated the players. Just manage a game of football. Give a free kick, give a throw, that's it. What are you getting involved in things for that are part of the game? Just crazy.
In terms of players and injuries, clearly a couple didn't make the game in Baldock and Egan. What's their situations?
Yeah, Eags, made the decision because he's not 100%. I knew it'd be a tough game. Lots of sprinting, lots of work. So, yeah, I wouldn't want to carry a player. He understands that, and he'll be better for it now. You know, a couple of days extra to get over it and prepare for next week.
He frustrated. He played for Republic of Ireland, or did that come into it?
Yeah, obviously, if he hadn't played, he'd have been fit. But we can't dictate to teams. It's an international break. They take precedent, then they take priority over it. Yeah, and we have to live with the consequences of it.
And George Baldock?
Injured again away, so he's got a calf issue that he'll take a couple of weeks.
Bogle came off as well. Was that cramp and the other players coming off? Yeah,
and Gus as well, and Maka.
Okay, thanks, Paul.
Cheers, mate.